Hi everyone, welcome back to AI Chatbot Masterclass. We have covered how to build a LinkedIn profile, what are the key things that you should keep in mind while building a good LinkedIn profile, and also we have covered the key terms that are used in sales and what is actually sales all about. In this session, we'll be mainly focusing on what type of content that you should put out in LinkedIn, and also most importantly, how you should structure your content and the growth hacks that are related to it. So without further ado, let's get started. So the very first thing is how to structure the content. See, there is a very famous marketing model that is used in the marketing agencies and the advertising agencies, that is AIDA model. Usually this model is implemented in the marketing sector only, and people tend to forget that in using it sales funnel as well as in content writing. But this is a very good model for content writing as well. So basically, what is AIDA model? A stands for attention, I stands for trust, D stands for desire, A stands for action. So we'll be taking one by one each and every term. So first is attention. The statement must attract the customer. It should be a type of eye catcher. So the opening statement of your content should be such that it holds the audience to read the entire content. Like for example, the eye catchers are 7x conversion, that is written in example. So if I would have to, you know, write a content about our product AI Timee, I would be writing like one of our clients generated 7x conversions using AI Timee. So that is something that everybody wants. Everybody wants conversions. So this is a line that actually has grabbed the attention of the audience. The next thing is interest. After getting the attention of the customer, the interest in the product or service should be aroused. Now you have got the attention of the customer. Now the next thing is to build interest. For example, not only just the conversions, but the conversations with the customer and customer journey also drastically improved, boosting customer engagement and retention rate. So we have actually told a little bit about our product as well, and we have generated interest as well. Next is desire. The next step is to persuade the customer that they want to own the product or service. Now you have to write such a thing that they should think that yes, this is the product I need to buy, this is the service I need to buy. For example, are you generating enough conversions this admission season? So they are actually going to question themselves that yes, we are not generating such conversions and we need that. So a desire is actually created inside them that yes, I want this product. Next is action. As soon as desire to buy is aroused, this must be transferred into action. That is the purchase. Now you have created interest, you have created desire, you have grabbed the attention as well. Last thing that is left is action to make them click on the purchase button. So you can write such a thing like, schedule a consultation now, book a demo by clicking on the link in the first comment. So you are giving an option to them that yes, you want this product, go to the link, book a consultation and buy the product. That is how the entire structure of your content should be. See, there is a very famous person in LinkedIn. The people who are using LinkedIn must be knowing Sam Bessler. He is one of the greatest influencers in LinkedIn. And if you gonna read his post, it actually is built on AIDA model. Like first three lines, do not read this post, keep scrolling. This is not for you if you're not serious about your business. It has actually psychologically created a attention of the audience. The next is, but if you want to learn how to generate B2B leads consistently using LinkedIn, then read on further. Why? Using these techniques, I built my LinkedIn network from 5K to 175K in 2 years. So this has created interest in the audience. Like if he can do that, we can also do that. And we want leads. The next thing is desire. Using these strategies, I built two successful and profitable startups, Brand Samosa and Decor Technologies, in less than 18 months. And these are similar tactics we use to help 50 plus B2B clients and 200 plus individual in lead generation, branding, marketing, and sales using LinkedIn. So these are the numbers that he has shown to actually maintain a social acceptance. That yes, 50 B2B clients have done that, 200+ individuals have done that, and I also want to do that. So the desire has been created. Now the last thing, all this I'm sharing in this free webinar on 11th August, and I promise I won't be selling anything in this webinar. Click the link in the first comment to join. So call to action statement is also there. So this is how you should structure your content. Now the next thing is, what type of content works on LinkedIn? Try to write down the experiences that you have faced in your life and what are the lessons and what are the outcomes that you have learned from those experiences. Because these are the things that people usually and very easily relate to, and it actually binds us together. So it will automatically boost the engagement and reach. Next is, give value so that people improve their business right away. Do not directly sell a product. If you are going on LinkedIn and just writing out that we have this product and this helps in generating so much of leads, if you want to buy that, click on this link. Nobody wanna click it because you haven't provided the value that what the other person is going to have after implementing the product or service. What are the results he's going to get? So you haven't personalized this. Most importantly, you are just directly selling it. So that's not how LinkedIn works. Next is, do not post direct links in LinkedIn posts. They reduce your reach and engagement. Usually put out the link in the comment section only. Do not put out the link in the content itself, because LinkedIn algorithm works in that way that it reduces your reach and engagement. That is something which is very common and you should understand it. Next is, ask people to engage with your content. Reach is directly proportional to engagement. Like at the end of the content, you should write, what are your views on this? Happy to hear that. So this is something that makes people comment on your post. And because of that, the reach increases and hence your engagement as well. Next is, divide post with paragraphs. This I have said n number of times already, that do not write the content or anything in paragraphs in long form, because nobody reads that and it's not easy to read also. So try using short paragraphs, single liners, put gap between them, and also because these short paragraphs are easier to read and mobile friendly. The next thing is LinkedIn tools for sales. So first LinkedIn tool that is very good and really important is Lucia. So this Chrome extension helps you to directly find the contact information of your prospect, both the email addresses and phone number as well. Download this extension, activate this extension, and when you visit anyone's profile on LinkedIn, then it will be gathering the information of that person, mainly the email addresses and the phone number. So you have got a lead by just directly visiting your client. That's it. As simple as that. The next LinkedIn tool is Hunter. It is also same extension just like Lucia, but the only difference is Lucia gives you phone number as well, whereas Hunter just gives you the email address. So if you want to do cold emailing, then you can actually use Hunter, or you can use both. It's all up to you. Next tool, and the most important tool I feel, is LinkedIn Helper, because it helps you to broadcast messages. Not just messages, but personalized messages. It is the most powerful tool for broadcasting messages in LinkedIn. You can send the personalized messages to n number of connections with a single click. I'll just show you how you can do that. For example, I want to broadcast a message to insurance sector. So I'll just click on search and write marketing manager, comma, insurance. Alright. Click on enter. Click on people. Click on connections and choose first connection, because these are the connections that are connected with us. Now click on these three buttons. Select message to first connection. Click on recipients and collect message recipients. So it will start collecting the people that are in the insurance sector and who are marketing managers. The time actually depends on the number of connections that you have. Since I have huge number of connections, so it will gonna take some time. I'll just stop the collecting messages recipients. I'll just view the collected recipients. These are the recipients that are collected. You can personally see each one of them. If you have already broadcasted messages, some of them, so you can select them and just delete from this list, and it's done. Click on close, click on message. I have already saved a message. You just write greetings. You can write the first name. You just have to click like that and it will be added, right? So these all are the personalized messages that you're gonna send. So if the person name is Tom, then it will be like greetings Tom. If it's Rohit, then it will be like greetings Rohit. We're in the insurance sector for the past 3 years, helping our clients generate 7x more conversions using AI timing, your personal insurance assistant. And just close it, click on yes, click close, click on broadcast, and just click on start broadcast messages, and people will start receiving the messages. It won't be in an instant. The messages won't be transferred to them in an instant. It will be taking time since it follows some of the LinkedIn algorithm as well, the tool itself. So it will be going to each one of the profiles and then will be sending messages to them personally. So that's how it works. In the next session, we'll be taking the pitch and proposal, how you should pitch the product to them and what are the things that you should include in the proposal. After this session, there will be a complete separate session for freelancing where all the freelancing tools, freelancing websites will be mentioned and will be explained in details how you should leverage them to generate leads and to generate freelancing business. That's it. Thanks.